And losers on Wall Street. Financial expert Rob Black joining us now to decipher what we're seeing in the headlines today. Rob, first of all, good morning.
Good morning. Good day. Good Monday.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, we're entering May. The markets, well, it depends on which indices you look at. Some up, some down. But I think in general, we're looking fairly positive, right?
Yeah, for sure. There's a bit of a reopening trade going on most of the market, but a little bit of a pullback in the big tech NASDAQ heavy names that have done so well over the last 18 months. There's a big April jobs report coming on the first Friday of this week that's really gonna probably change the tone of the market for better or for worse. S&P 500's up 11% for the year, which is fantastic considering we're one third done. We're also in May, and they say sell in May, go away for the next 3 to 6 months, as that's the area where the market tends to get choppiest. Of note, people have bought pools last year. Chlorine's going to be up about 60% year over year, as there's going to be a big shortage, pandemic, oddball thing.
Huh.
And Apple, it's been widely rumored, and now it's expected 2023, a foldable phone that'll be bigger than an iPad mini. So it'll be about 8 inches. It'll be a phone / iPad. I guess we should look forward to that, but I don't know. It seems a little heavily pushed.
You're not sold on that, huh?
Not yet.
Okay, very good, very good. Let's talk. I know Warren Buffett had his annual shareholders meeting. I'm kind of interested to see what his take was on these meme stocks, which was sort of like the flavor of the month here over the past couple of months. Did he talk at all about that? Have you heard?
A little bit.
Okay.
He has his annual shareholder meeting, and it's typically in person. It's awesome. He eats Dairy Queen, drinks Coca-Cola, eats McDonald's, things that he invests in, he kind of shares with the crowd. And he's the most important investor in my lifetime. To a sports figure, he'd be like the Willie Mays. He's the greatest of all time. There's no doubt about it. He said, be wary of inflation. To your point, he said, be wary of things like Robin Hood. Because even though you're young and beautiful today, if you go back 30 years ago, the top 20 companies in the world, none of them are the top 20 that now. He thinks index funds are better for the average person than anything else. He had a huge loser last year. He sold Delta, American, Southwest, United. And everyone's like, why did you sell at the bottom? He came out and told us. He said, I didn't want to bail them out. I thought they were going to go bankrupt, and I thought we were going to bail them out. So he doesn't take risk is a lesson that I love. He referred to Apple as one of the four crown jewel, or one of the four jewels in the crown, which is quite the compliment. And his partner, Charlie Munger, 97 years old. Keep in mind, Warren Buffett's 90. They talked a little bit about Bitcoin, and Munger called it dangerous and disgusting.
Oh.
He thinks that anytime like a big media organization or a big financial organization gets hacked, they're paying in Bitcoin and it's illegal and it should go away. But keep in mind, Buffett and Munger didn't really own tech stocks in the 1990s, and it took 15 years for them to get involved in Apple. They'll be long dead before we can judge whether they're right or wrong in Bitcoin, but neither seem to like it much.
Okay, they're not fans, at least we're not right now anyway. And then we have to touch quickly on Verizon. Big headline coming out of there. They sold Yahoo and AOL for $5 billion, which sounds like a lot of money, but I think they took a loss on that, didn't they?
Yeah, they paid $4.4 billion for AOL and $4.5 billion for Yahoo. I bring it up as Daria brought up the beached whale on the beach this weekend. That wasn't a whale, that was me. And the kids were trying to push me back in the water. Yahoo's been a beached whale. And everyone's trying to figure it out. Verizon just can't do it. They're dead. They're internet superhighway roadkill at this point in time. They're being sold to a private equity company that will try to get some value out of them and bring them back public. But it's a dismantling of a company that I've known for 25 years since being in the Bay Area. And they just, they're falling and they can't get back up. They're a beach whale, they can't get back in the water. Whatever analogy you want to say, it's kind of like a farewell today to Yahoo and Marissa Meyer and all the attempts that they made to try to save the company, which was so important to the first dot-com boom in the Bay Area. Yahoo and Google were the cornerstones. And again, it didn't take but 15 years for Yahoo to completely disappear almost.
Yeah, and AOL was huge, so huge back in the day.
Now, do you remember those mailers?
What's that?
Do you remember getting in the mail every day?
Oh, yeah, the disc.
5,000 free hours.
Yep. Yeah, times have changed. Rob, thank you as always. Send Rob your questions. He'll answer them for you and maybe even share them on air if you'd like. We've got contact information for him there on the screen. Facebook, Twitter, email him directly, and always connect with him on our website at cronford.com.